Okay, this is day 80, water rinsing only. I have been doing it for 80 days and my hair still feels really great. In my last video, I said I would come back on here and show you what it looks like while it's wet. And this is it. Hopefully you can see. I've already been out of the shower for about, I want to say 10 minutes, and the hair is almost dry. You'll see that it's still wet at the very ends. But that's pretty much where most of my moisture is. I know for us naturals, a lot of times when we put products in our hair, the dryness starts at the ends and it works its way to the root. Usually all up in here, we'll find that it's still wet the next day after applying products to it. Well, when you're on this method, when you're using this method, that's not the case. Your hair dries faster from the root down. I think it's because the sebum is basically weatherproof to some degree, and the water basically, it just kind of trickles down off of your hair, glides down as if, I guess I want to compare it to if you were to have an oil spill, you know, on the ground or on your floor somewhere, and then you added water to it, it just glides off. Okay, the water just glides off of your hair. And so right now, I have water drip from my very ends. And you can see that my hair is clumpy together really nicely. It's very shiny. It's curly like it usually is when I add product to it. Only this is, nothing's been added to it except for my own oils. So this is what it looks like while it's wet. I was afraid that it would dry before I could actually make the video. So let's see. Okay, something new that I realized today while I was rinsing. I can now literally feel the sebum on my hands while I'm massaging the oils down my length. It feels really, really sticky and tacky, like I put wax on my hair. Once my hair dries, you can't feel that. It just feels really, really soft and supple. But when you reach total coverage, it's going to be very trippy to feel your hair while it's wet and then to know that you're transferring the wax onto your hands. That feels very weird. If you receive coverage a lot sooner than what I did, because like I said, this is the first time that I've actually had this experience while using this particular method of having the waxiness transferred to my hands. So who knows, maybe you produce more sebum than I do, and so you'll reach it a lot sooner. And like I said, this is day 80 for me. So it's very trippy that, you know, there's so much on my hair that it's getting on my hands. And so, yeah, that, I guess that's something that's new. And let's see. Well, okay, usually when my hair dries, what I'll do is I'll bantu knot it up, because when it's in this particular style, it shrinks up. Not too much. It's already shrinking right now. But I generally like to do bantu knots because it gives a lot of fullness that you saw in the last video. This is kind of boring to me just with it straight like this. So yeah, I usually do bantu knots. And you can see, let's see if you can see up in there. I'm not sure how well you can see, but my hair actually needs to be retwisted. But it is very, very soft. And the sebum actually lays down the little hairs that I have growing here. Like, generally when I get out of the, when I wake up in the morning and I take off my scarf, the little hairs are just kind of plastered on my face. So this is a really good method for me to be on right now. It's very carefree. I really don't have to do much to it at all. So I guess that's it. It's one of those days, so I don't really have a lot to talk about, or that I at least feel like talking about. I will come back on in, I want to say, 10 days. And I'll talk about scritching, massaging, and just the general things that I do on a weekly basis to my hair. Okay, thank you. Bye.